One of the things that we've seen from a Flex Era report last year is that over 50% of developers are using EKS. And of course, that has a large overlap with where our VMware customers are. And our goal is to meet VMware customers on their Kubernetes journey. And to do that, the first thing that we're hoping to do is to make it really easy for developers or operators to create a cluster, an EKS cluster, directly from Tanzu Mission Control. By doing that, we enable operations teams to centrally manage all of the clusters and access that they need, but we also give developers a simple one-click experience with kind of the best practice and easy access for wherever they need to access their clusters. So, at a very high level, the experience that we're looking to provide for EKS lifecycle management in Tanzu Mission Control is relatively straightforward. Step one is your operations team will add an EKS account directly into TMC. They'll do this by running a CloudFormation template in their Amazon account, which gives TMC access to their Amazon account on their behalf. After that, TMC will have delegated access to the Amazon account with the right permissions to create EKS clusters. And so anyone with access to that account can then use TMC to create an EKS cluster. And once that cluster is there, it'll behave just like any other cluster in TMC. You can apply policies, you can grant access, and you can deploy workloads with GitOps, which Nick will be talking about in a minute. If we dive a tiny bit deeper into how does EKS lifecycle work, the first thing is we've introduced this new service that runs in the TMC infrastructure called a managed Kubernetes provider. This managed Kubernetes provider is responsible for calling the EKS APIs to create a new cluster. EKS would then create that cluster based on this definition that the user provided. At the same time, that managed Kubernetes provider service in TMC is also going to create a Lambda function in the AWS account. That Lambda function will periodically spin up and is responsible for monitoring the cluster health and will install the TMC agent when it's ready. It's really this kind of this Lambda that's responsible until the TMC cluster agent comes up. That's responsible for reporting back to TMC the health and status of the cluster. And then once the cluster is up, again, it'll behave just like any other cluster.